Today we're going to be doing the Diffusion Assay, testing different antimicrobials for their ability to inhibit the growth of a particular microorganism. This day we're working with E. coli. So to begin, we have to streak a confluent lawn of bacteria on our nutrient auger plate. Get your Bunsen burner ready and use a sterile swab to collect the bacteria from the culture tube. Do not flame this swab, it is already sterile and it will catch on fire if you flame it. So you take the culture that you're putting on the plate, aseptically collect enough of the broth on your sterile swab. Try to get a little bit of the broth out. Then you will be making a confluent lawn of bacteria on your plate. So you streak the plate completely all the way down, going side to side across the plate. You then rotate the plate and do the same thing all the way down 3 to 4 times. Once you've streaked all the way down, take your swab and do a final ring around the plate. Once you're done with your swab, you discard it in the benchtop biohazard bucket. In order to place the diffusion discs onto your auger plate, you have to take the appropriate forceps from the ethyl alcohol, shake off the residual liquid on the forceps, collect one of the paper diffusion discs located at the bench, and dip it into the appropriate antimicrobial. Once it's fully saturated, you place it in the appropriate region of your petri plate and press it gently into the media. And make sure to put the forceps back into the ethanol once you're done. You move to the other antimicrobial agents by grabbing the corresponding forceps to the antimicrobial agent so you're not cross-contaminating them. And again, grab one paper disc, dip it into the antimicrobial agent, and place it gently into the media, returning the forceps to the ethanol alcohol. Once you've finished putting all the discs onto your plate, you have to invert it. Do not worry, the discs will not fall from the media, and you will store them where your instructor tells you to until next lab period. After the plate is done incubating, you'll see that the confluent lawn has grown up around the plate, except for any zone of inhibition around each of the discs. This may differ organism to organism, but if there is any clearing around the disc, that means that that antimicrobial inhibited the growth of that organism. So in conclusion, to use disc diffusion assays, you have to begin by making a confluent lawn of bacteria. This is done by using a sterile swab, swabbing across the plate 3 to 4 times and once around the perimeter of the plate. Once you've made your confluent lawn of bacteria, you take the appropriate diffusion disc, soak it into the antimicrobial agent, and place it gently onto your plates. Make sure to invert the plates as you incubate it.